Philippine shares plunged 2% and pulled back to the 7,200 level, joining the global sell-off on Thursday ahead of a local national holiday. The worldwide risk aversion as Russia began military action in Ukraine. Value turnover was thinner than usual, but the country saw foreign funds position for 748 million pesos. Union Bank Chief Investment Officer Julian Tarubago says the volatility may linger.
The main risk there in the short term is that if the tensions escalate into an actual shooting war, and if it drags the U.S. into the fray, the doomsday scenario is eased somehow in our view by one, the conflict likely remaining localized in eastern Ukraine, with this likely to be met by sanctions and diplomacy instead of direct troop deployment. If you look at recent history of geopolitical conflict, these typically, at least based on recent history, do not last very long, and on average impacts equity markets on average by about mid single digits. So it's a significant concern for the short term.
AB Capital Securities equities trader Sara Santos also says not even the possible easing of curbs in NCR was able to prop up the local bourse.
So the reopening of the economy is already factored in by the market. So with the support levels, the support is by increments of 100. So that's 7,100 levels up to the 7,000 level.
For the month, the Philippine Stock Exchange Index is also down 2%. Mining and oil managed to eke out gains for the day as Phoenix Petroleum rallied almost 12%. In a disclosure, PXP cut its 2021 net loss to 32.5 million pesos from almost 46 million the year before on the back of improved petroleum revenues. But the most active stock, Metro Bank, which also reported 2021 earnings to have surged 60% to over 22 billion pesos, closed 0.5% lower. Stanley Palisada, ABS-CBN News.